how to fight loan shark harassment in the Philippines. Petition to stop loan shark group. How to fight loan sharks harassment in the Philippines. Many people find themselves at the short end of the stick when it comes to money. While it is normal for people to run out of funds, some take advantage of this bad situation and profit them. Today, let us look at what loan sharks are and how you could avoid them. What are loan sharks? A loan shark is a person who offers to lend money at high interest rate, while other legitimate organizations do the same thing. What makes a loaner a shark different is violence. If you do not pay them, they will harass you and your phone contacts, family, friends, co-workers, and bosses. The interests are also so high that they are beyond what is legally reasonable. Most of the time, loan sharks are members of organized crime organizations like the Mafia, Yakuza, and others. Some do not resort to violence, but they put you at a disadvantage. Types of loan sharks in the Philippines. There are many main types of loan sharks Philippines. These are the 5-6 Sangla ATM, financing company, lending company, and online lending apps. 5-6 loans. This is a kind of loan where you borrow 5 pesos and pay 6. If you do the calculation, you are paying 20% on your loan. Some banks do charge this level of interest, but within many years. A loan shark, however, charge this interest per month. Sangla ATM. The word sangla means phone. In a loan shark scheme like this, the borrower must surrender his ATM card to the lender, along with his password or PIN code. The borrower will not be able to get his ATM card back unless the payment has been made. As you can see, the borrower in both types of loan sharking is in a bad spot. If you do not have your ATM with you, you will not be able to withdraw and you will have no money to spend for your day-to-day living. The ATM card, by the way, is how the borrower gets his salary from his employer. Financing loan modus. They will ask you to sign blank documents, blank checks, blank amount, and blank date what they use to blackmail you if they want. Online lending apps. They will threaten you to post in social media, harass you and your contacts, families, friends, and co-worker if you fail to pay them back on the seventh day of your loan. Signs of an illegal money lender. How would you know if the lender is a loan shark? Here are some warning signs and red flags. There is no contracts. Loan sharks don't let you sign any contracts, either on paper or online, with a signature from a SMS. They do not want to tie themselves with contracts like that. A contract is an evidence, and they do not want you to have that proof. No clear expectations. While loan sharks tell you the amount of interest, they do not tell you the consequences if you fail to pay on time. If you do not pay, they will ask you to pay more, which you never knew was a rule or agreement in the first place. If you do not comply with this demand, they will harass you, force you to give your bank account. Loan shark will typically ask you to hand over your ATM card. If not, they will ask for something of value like your motorcycle or jewelry. They call this collateral. What you do not know is that they will sell this if you fail to pay. High interest rates. A loan sharks tend to charge much more money than banks and loan companies. Even if the interest on a bank loan is high, you pay it back evenly over several months. In the case of the ATM, the loan shark will withdraw money from it until you have paid your debt. On many occasions, the loan shark will withdraw money from it and then just give you enough to pay for what you need to pay your bills. If you ever ask the bank to disable that ATM card, the loan shark is going to harass and hurt you. Comparison table. Legal lender and illegal lender. Activity: loan shark over legal lender. Extremely high over extremely high follows legal standard. Takes your ATM card, yes over no. Background check, no over yes. Formal loan contract, no over yes. Transactions are recorded, no over yes. Requires an advance fee, yes over no. Harasses you if you do not pay, yes over no. As you can see, loan sharks put you at extreme risk. If the interest is so high, you will be paying more money on interest than the principal amount of your loan. If they take your ATM card, they will also take your password. They can wipe out your salary if they want to also. You may be forced to withdraw over the counter in the bank. And this is a time-consuming process. If there is no background check, it only means that the loan shark does not really care about your financial well-being. Banks do. If the bank does not think you can afford what you are loaning for, then you cannot get a loan. As such, the bank is doing you a favor of not burying yourself in too much debt. All transactions in the bank have a record. This record is evidence of the truth. A loan shark, on the other hand, does not do this. Do you know what this means? It means that a loan shark can easily say you did not pay last month, even if you did. If you disagree with what the loan shark is saying, he will harass you. Loan sharks also typically get an advance fee. It means that if you borrow 1,000 pesos with an interest of 20%, the loan shark will only give you 800 pesos. In that example, you still owe 1,000 pesos, not 800 pesos. Why? If you borrow 1,000, the loan shark expect to get a total of 1,200 pesos from you. Since you only paid 200 pesos as an advance fee, you still owe 1,000 pesos to him. Online loan apps. If you borrow the amount of 2,000, you will receive 1,200 and you will pay 2,200 in 7 days. And on the 7th day before your due date, they will threaten you to debt shaming. Philippine law against loan sharks. Are there laws that protect consumers from loan shark? Yes, there are. For one, the legal interest Philippine is regulated. You cannot just loan money and charge as much interest as you want. For further reading, you can check on the following. Republic Act number 9474 or the Lending Company Regulation Act of 2007. Republic Act number 8556 or the Financing Company Act of 1998. 18th Congress. Senate Resolution Number 121. Republic Act Number 3765 or the Truth in Lending Act. If a lender violates any of these laws, you can file a complaint and take them to court. The Truth in Lending Act is also called TILA. It basically says that if you loan money to somebody, you have to disclose everything about the loan to the borrower. Failure to do this is a violation of the law. How to keep out the loan sharks? There are many laws about loan sharks in the Philippines. If you want to know the Philippine law against loan sharks, you have to read the list of all the best loans. We have a list of all companies that allows you to verify if the company is legit or not. In essence, all the best loans made it easier for people to check if the lender is operating legally or if it is a loan shark. Here are some tips on how to fight loan shark harassment, Philippines. Save money. Do not put yourself in a position where you are out of funds. Avoid spending frivolously and make sure you have an emergency fund that you can count on. Do not take cash loans. If somebody offers you a cash loan, do not take it. Loan sharks are friendly at first. Then, they will harass you if you fail to pay. Only borrow from legit companies. If you are ever short on funds, only borrow money from the bank. While banks have a lot of documentary requirements, it is better to borrow money this way because they will not harass you. Now, you have to know that loan sharks are friendly at first. They will project themselves as the solution to your financial woes. What you do not realize is that they are baiting you into a trap that you cannot get out of. If you are a victim of loan sharks, there is a way to report Loan Shark Philippines. You can go to the office of the Securities and Exchange Commission and then file a complaint. Here are some tips. Fill out the complaint form completely. Make sure you attach relevant documents and proof to support your complaint. Provide a valid government ID. Make sure you have used everything in your power to resolve the issue with the loan shark. All in all, you must avoid getting yourself in this situation. Do not borrow money from illegal lenders if you are not sure whether the loaner is legal or illegal. It is better to err on the side of caution. Conclusion: be careful of loan sharks. They are out to get you, and they will be there in your most vulnerable times. If you ever need money It is better to seek the help of your friends, relatives, banks, and other legal and fair companies that's not put you in deep debt.